The last time you bought a new iPhone, why did you buy it? Was it because you were excited about some new feature? Or like most people, did your old iPhone just get old? Meaning, did it get slower? Did the battery start to die faster? And I'm worried, because the more I've used iOS 26, the more the fancy new visual effects feel like a way to drain your battery faster and slow down your iPhone. I don't want your phone to become an old iPhone overnight. The first setting I'd like to talk about is background app refresh. So let's head to the settings app. I'll tap to open that up. Then I'll scroll down to general and tap on that. Then I'll scroll down to background app refresh and tap on that to open it up. Background app refresh allows the apps on your iPhone to download new content in the background when you're not using them. As you can imagine, that uses battery life and processor power. In the world of iPhones, nothing comes without a cost. The cost of background app refresh is battery life and speed. I recommend just using background app refresh on Wi-Fi. I'll tap on that at the top, background app refresh, and just choose Wi-Fi. Of course, you could turn it all the way off, but I don't recommend that because background app refresh is a good feature for apps like mail or messages. But for other apps, it's just not necessary. I'll tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. It's probably a long list of apps on your phone, just like mine. But for instance, if I scroll down here and look at Airbnb, I don't need Airbnb to download new content in the background when I'm not using the app. So what I'll do is I'll tap the switch to the right of it to turn it off. But with iOS 26 coming out, I'm taking a tip that I usually put at the bottom of the list and moving it up to the top. So we're gonna head to accessibility settings. I'll tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, and then I'm going to tap back again to the main page of settings. Then I'll tap here on accessibility, and I'm gonna scroll down to motion and tap to open up that menu. Like I said a minute ago, iOS 26 comes with a whole bunch of fancy new visual effects built in. They look pretty cool, but they're gonna use a lot more battery life and processor power than the current visual effects on your iPhone. At the very bottom is this limit frame rate setting. I'll tap to turn that on. This sets the maximum frame rate of the iPhone's display to 60 frames per second, as opposed to ProMotion, which is the default, and allows your iPhone to go all the way up to 120 frames per second. For comparison, the video you're watching right now is 24 frames a second, which is a lot less than 120 frames per second, obviously. 60 frames per second is also really fast and very smooth. So by turning this switch on, we limit the frame rate, and it makes sense because the frame rate is essentially how many times per second your iPhone updates what's on the screen. And if it goes from 120 updates a second to 60 updates a second, that's a lot less battery life used. While we're in here, bonus setting, if you use your iPhone in the car and you get car sick, turn on show vehicle motion cues. I'll tap to open that up and just put it on automatic. Then these little dots appear on the side of your phone when you're traveling, and it actually cuts down on motion sickness. Next, I'll tap back to motion in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, back to accessibility. And let's open up the display and text size menu. Then I'm going to turn on the switch next to reduce transparency. This is a setting that's going to make more of a difference in iOS 26 than ever before, because Apple's new liquid glass look is all about transparency. By reducing that visual rendering that's happening all the time, your phone battery is going to last longer. And I guarantee you, as soon as iOS 26 comes out, there are gonna be a ton of battery life complaints about it. Now that we've got these display settings under control, I wanna show you how to override them for specific apps, because maybe there's some app on your phone that doesn't look right or doesn't feel as good as it used to. The good news is that now you can turn off all of this stuff per app. So basically, what we've done so far is set a default. Now I'm gonna go back to the main page of accessibility and scroll all the way to the bottom, and we have per app settings. Tap on that, and I'll tap add app. I'll use Ace Hardware as an example, just picking a random app. Then I'll tap to open up Ace Hardware, and the settings that we just changed can now be switched off for this specific app. So I'll tap reduce transparency, and instead of the default, I'll turn it to off. Tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. Similarly, down here at the bottom, reduce motion, we'll tap on that and we'll turn this switch off. So to recap, we changed the default settings and now you can go in and override them for specific apps that you want to look zippier if there's a problem or if you even notice a difference. Next, let's head to App Store settings. I'll sway back from left to right on the screen, and back again, and back again, instead of hitting those little tiny back buttons in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. Then I'm going to scroll to the top of settings. Now in the search bar, I'll just type in App Store. And I'll tap to open up the App Store section of settings. And right here, we see app downloads. Make sure that app downloads is turned off because if it's on and you download an app on a different Apple device, it will automatically download on this iPhone, which obviously uses battery life, and it's actually really annoying. App updates and in-app content, I say leave them on. While we're here, let's scroll down to video autoplay. I'll tap to open that up. Video autoplay automatically plays app preview videos in the App Store. If you like those, leave it on. If you don't, Wi-Fi only will save you battery life and cellular data. Let's tap back to App Store. And in-app ratings and reviews, this isn't gonna save your battery or speed up your phone, but it is gonna save you a headache. So I'll tap to turn that switch off. Now, apps aren't going to ask if you liked them enough to give a 5-star review after you've used them for 10 seconds. Next, some settings that don't just slow your phone down, they affect your privacy too. Let's head to the privacy section of settings. I'll tap back, and then back again to the main page of settings, and I'll tap cancel, and then I'll scroll down here to privacy and security and tap on that. Then we're gonna scroll all the way to the bottom to analytics and improvements, tap to open that up, and make sure that all of these analytics settings are turned off. For me, I'll just turn off this share iPhone and watch analytics at the top, and then I'm gonna turn off all of these other switches. This is gonna speed up your phone because obviously if your phone is collecting data and sending it to app developers or to Apple in the background, well, that is using battery life and slowing down your iPhone. Next, tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and scroll to the top to tracking and tap to open up that menu. The more I've learned about what happens under the hood of your iPhone and what this tracking section actually means for you and your actual privacy, the more I've been a little bit freaked out by it. I'll use the chess app as an example. What can happen is you're at the doctor's office and you're playing chess while you wait for your appointment. Your phone pings a GPS tower. Now you're at home and you're playing chess. Your phone pings another GPS tower and you play chess the next day and the next day and ping, ping, ping. Your iPhone is pinging GPS towers all over the place. Why is this bad? Well, just from that GPS pinging, an advertiser was able to find out that a specific woman had visited a reproductive health clinic and target her based on that information. How? The app developer on her phone wasn't just using all these pings for the app itself. They were selling them to a data broker. And even though that data broker didn't get the woman's name directly, all they had to do was see that, okay, this phone is at a specific house over and over again, and that's probably where she lives. They looked up the address, saw who lives there. You don't have to be a genius to put two and two together here. Is it legal? Absolutely. Is it a good thing? I don't think so. And that's where a service like Incogni really comes in handy. Normally, you'd have to go to a data broker website, you'd fill out a bunch of forms, they would verify your identity, and hopefully, eventually, they'd remove your data. But there are hundreds of these data brokers out there, and you don't have time to go to each website, and neither do I. Incogni has automated the process. So all you do is enter your information once, and they take care of the rest. Call me crazy, but I don't want a data broker to be able to type in David Payette and find out what doctor's offices I go to. You don't want that either. If you want to give Incogni a try, you can get 60% off an annual plan with coupon code Payette, P-A-Y-E-T-T-E, my last name. I want to thank Incogni for sponsoring this video too. I'll drop a link in the description section and the pinned comment below. So back to the tracking menu of your iPhone. Turn off Allow Apps to Request to Track here at the top, and then just tap Ask Apps to Stop Tracking. And it will automatically turn off all the switches for all the apps on this page. It's easy. Let's tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. We'll tap into Location Services. I always say to be careful of any apps that say always in this list, because then the IFTTT app, for instance, is always able to track my location. And like we just talked about, if it's always gathering my data, it's got a lot more data to sell to a data broker. So I'll tap into if this, then that, IFTTT. I'll change it to while using the app and I'll turn off precise location. So now even if they were to sell it, they're not gonna get my home address at least. I'll tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and scroll to the bottom to System Services, and let's tap to open that menu up. I'll save this whole list for a different video, but the one I want to talk about this time is significant locations. I'll tap on that to open it up. You'll have to enter your passcode, and you can go ahead and just turn that off because it'll speed up your iPhone and save a little bit of battery life. It's true that all of these tips make your iPhone just a little bit faster, but when you add them all up, your iPhone can feel a lot faster. And that's kind of what I'm hoping is gonna happen for you. I'll tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and let's scroll down to product improvement and turn off all of these switches. We don't need to be sending this data to Apple. Next, let's tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and back again to the main page of settings. I'm gonna scroll all the way to the top just by tapping here at the top. Then I'll tap into the search menu and I'm gonna type in mail. M-A-I-L, and tap to open that up. Then I'm gonna scroll down to mail accounts. Actually, it's right here at the top, and tap to open that up. Then I'm gonna tap on fetch new data. I've talked about this setting before, but it's very important. We're gonna change mail here from push to fetch. Push means your iPhone maintains a connection to the email server. So as soon as an email arrives, it gets pushed instantly to your phone, which would be great if it wasn't constantly draining your battery and slowing down your phone. The alternative is fetch, where instead of your iPhone constantly being connected to the email server, you choose how often it checks to see if a new message has arrived. So I'll just turn off push here at the top, and then we'll choose how often to fetch. I just choose every 15 minutes here at the bottom. You can see here it says, for better battery life, fetch less frequently. And what uses battery also slows down your phone. Therefore, for a faster phone, fetch less frequently. Is that math? I think that's math. If P, then Q, Q, then R. Does that make sense? I don't know. Changing push to fetch can have a huge impact on battery life, especially for those of you who, like me, have more than one mail account. Let's head back to the main page of settings. Swiping from left to right this time. Just keep on swiping and then cancel out of the search here. And I'll scroll down to Apple Intelligence and Siri. Let's open up that menu. When it comes to AI, Siri isn't the sharpest knife in the drawer, but it is kind of what Apple's been working on. So I would hate to tell you to turn off a feature that is so much of what iOS 26 is all about, because I don't want you to miss out on all the new stuff they're coming out with. But if you're having problems with performance, like if your phone is just feeling really slow, or your battery's dying really fast, or in other words, if your phone is just feeling old, tap the switch here at the top, and then tap turn off Apple Intelligence. You can live without it. Some of you are gonna see a huge benefit just from doing this. If you wanna use good AI, go to the App Store and try either ChatGPT or Claude. They're both great. It's actually the reason I'm wearing a green shirt today. I asked ChatGPT how I could stand out from this YouTube set. ChatGPT said the green would pop. Anyway, we go through these settings really quick, and there are a bunch of them. Lately, I've been thinking more about YouTube memberships and how I want that feature to work on my channel. I'm super grateful for those of you who have supported me over the years by being YouTube channel members. But what I think I'm gonna do moving forward, or at least for this video, is just make the new PDFs that used to be for members only available for everybody to download. I'm just gonna try giving away more stuff to everybody and just ask you to support the channel if you're in a position to do that by becoming a YouTube channel member or giving a super thanks. So there's a link to a PDF that you can download and even print out with all the settings we've talked about in this video in the description section below. I'm really looking forward to next month. There's gonna be a lot of big videos coming out, especially with the launch of iOS 26. And until then, I'll see you here.